Hello everyone, peace of Christ to all. Lately we hear about what happened in the DNC conference for what is called Democrat. They brought a Muslim man who his son died as a soldier in the USA Army. And for sure they brought him for a reason. Let us make it clear, this was meant to be a reason to attack Trump, and it was planned for. So Trump and his team should be smarter, and they know that there is a trap behind it, because now you are bringing someone who his son died in the war, supposedly defending this country. Now before we go further, and I hope everybody will share this video, it doesn't matter if you are an American or not, because in order to understand how Muslims think and how scumbags like Hillary Clinton think, we need to understand how to answer them and how to learn to answer them. First of all, me myself, I joined the USA Army. And the second you sign the agreement to join the troops, you understand very well that this is an army. You are not going to go to Hawaii for fishing. You are going and properly, you will not come back. Actually, most likely you might get killed because you are going in war. So when I signed the agreement with the USA Army to join, I was a hero? I don't think so. You know, every citizen, especially this is a volunteer thing you do, every citizen, he do his duty in this country. A nurse, she go to hospital. A doctor, she go to her clinic. An engineer, he build a bridge. The guy who collect the garbage outside, he keep our city clean. And the soldier, he keep the country protected. Simply, it's a job. Now, we call it a hero job because supposedly you are sacrificing something and you are risking your life. But this is not a reason to make it as a reason to insult everybody and make everybody else as no one. So what those people they are doing in their propaganda, they are trying to use a soldier who died, and he have nothing to do with this election. He died 12 years ago. And they are trying to use him as a method to win the election. And they are trying to make Trump, he's a person who don't respect American soldiers. First of all, let me ask a question for the Muslim, the father of this Abdul. And I call him Abdul, by the way, because I don't believe there is one Muslim he joined the American army because he loves America. And I will explain to you why. When you call yourself a Muslim, are you serious? Because there's one of two options. Either this man is an honest man, and really he loves America, and that will not make him a Muslim, or he's a liar, and he's a scam, and he is trying to be used. God knows how much they paid him to come in this stage and to use him in their propaganda. And everything is possible. I will not be surprised if a big gift is coming to him, little check from Clinton for the help he is doing. Let me explain to you why I'm saying there is no Muslim ever will join the USA Army. And he mean it. In the Quran, when we say a Muslim, what does that mean? When we say a Christian, what does that mean? When we say a Hindu, a Muslim is someone who follows his book, the Quran. A Christian, he is the one who follows Jesus. As simple as that. So if you don't follow Islam, don't call yourself Muslim. Call yourself atheist. So do you follow Islam? He will say yes, because he's calling himself a Muslim. If we go to the Quran, we will see the Quran saying clearly. And this is chapter 5, verse 51. And we can use any translation of your choice. Please feel free to add as many as translation. By the way, I don't accept any of them, because all the Muslim translations try to make Islam look nicer. However, I will show you all the possible translation we can find here. To make you out of excuses. As you see with me here, the verse is so clear. It's saying that Muslim cannot take Christians and Jews as a friends or protectors. And the one who do that, and please read with me. I'm assuming that you know how to read, how to write, and you are a little bit educated, not like Muhammad, the prophet of the Abdul. It says, O who you believe, take not the Christian and the Jews as a friends or protectors. So take a note, please. A real Muslim, he will never accept to take the Christians as friends or protectors. So how this soldier who joined the US Army, who died in the war in Afghanistan, he is going to protect me, or I'm going to protect him if you don't accept me to be a friend? So what we are enemies. When a Muslim, he said, I cannot take you as a friend, it means I cannot take you as a friend, for you are an enemy. When a Muslim, he said, I cannot take you as a protector, it means your army cannot be my army. So when this Abdul, he says to us, he's a Muslim, and his son, he went to war. Now, someone of you might say to me, well, how you explain then his son, he went to war? Hold on, before we continue. It says here, and whoever of you friend them and protect them, they are, the Christian and the Jews, they are protectors and friends to each other only. And whoever of you, among you, he turns to them in a friendship, he is one of them. So according to this Quran, and this is what this Abdul, he follow, the one who take us as a friend, and he take us as a protector, he is not a Muslim no more. The verse in the front of you, I'm not saying anything. All right? I'm not the one saying that. And you can read all translation you want. Feel free. All right? So if you are a person who likes to play games, all the translation are in front of you. Anyone he take us as a friend or protectors, he's one of us. He's not a Muslim no more. So why you claim to be a Muslim? Are you for real taking us as a friends or protectors? If he say yes, it means he isn't a Muslim. So therefore, saying that he is a Muslim is a scam. Or he is lying to us, saying he is friend to us when he is not. How is that can be? If you remember once before, I have a debate with an imam. And this imam, his name is Hisham al-Husayni. I'm not sure if you remember him. Hisham al-Husayni was interviewed in Fox News many times, and he is the leader of the Shia in the whole state of Michigan. Now, this guy, he was hired by Department of Defense. He have a contract with them for a few years, and he was called a consultant for George Bush. Why he accepted the job? Those are Shia Muslims. What does that mean? If the war America will go is for the benefit of the Shia, why the Shia will not join the war? So this man, he was recruiting even Shia to join the USA Army. But for them, they are not joining the army really. They are fighting their enemies, which is Saddam Hussein. Same as in Kabul, in Afghanistan. The Shia, they are number one beneficiary from the war of America in Afghanistan because they were losing ground. And the soldier we are talking about here is a Shia. And even if he is a Sunni, as I showed you, he is not allowed to take us as a friend or protectors. Now, the Shia, they go, and Muslim, by the way, Muslim Sunni, they can go in war. Like right now, the Muslim Sunni in Syria, they are kissing the shoes of Obama to attack the Syrian government. But yet they cannot take us as a protectors. And they cannot take us as a friends. They are not taking us as a friends or protectors. They are using us. So when they join the US Army, if the army is attacking for their benefit, they join. Why not? It's just 2 years contract. By the time the war will be over, he will be leaving. And as you remember, chapter 3, verse 28, encourage Muslim to use what is called taqiyya. And you can read in front of you, you can freeze the screen, and you can read carefully, and you will see the Quran encouraging Muslims to lie to non-Muslims. They cannot take them as a friends, as we showed you. The same as there's many verses, by the way, it says you cannot take them as a friends. You cannot take them as a protectors. And supposedly the Quran call us the hypocrites. Alright? But if you want to take them as a friends in the way of protection, which means you don't mean it, it's fine. The God of Islam have no problem with it. We can change that interpretation for the verse so nobody will say I'm picking up my cherries. Read with me carefully. You cannot take them as a friend. And if he would take him as a friend, the one who did that, okay, the one who take the disbelievers or Jews or Christian, doesn't matter, atheist, and became mighty and honorable. Who are sincere. So if a Muslim he is sincere and he take me as a friend, what will happen? Those who do that, seeking might and honor by taking the hypocrites, which mean you and me, and the disbelievers as friends, he has no connection with Allah, which means he is not a Muslim. Do you see it? If a Muslim is a sincere, listen carefully, I'm not the one saying that. This is the God of the Abdul. If a Muslim is a sincere to take us as a friend, he has no connection with Allah. He is not a Muslim. So why the scumbag Hillary Clinton, she is bringing this guy saying a Muslim soldier father, when in fact he is no Muslim, unless he is practicing taqiyya. Let us see what taqiyya is. The Quran explains what is taqiyya. So if you take them as a friend, the one who do that, he has no honor, no mercy or protection from Allah, which means Muslim should kill him. Unless you guard yourself against them, save yourself from them. Token as it were security. Saving yourself from them by what? By speaking in a friendly way while toward them, while your heart is like this. That is Islam, my friends, and this is what those Muslims are doing. They are practicing taqiyya. When the war goes for their benefit, they join the war. Why not? But they don't take you as a friend. And this soldier who is called an American soldier hero, he is no American, and he is no soldier for America, unless he is not a Muslim. And as long his family confirmed that they are a Muslim family, then I have to go by this, the Quran, in front of me, because this is mean that this soldier, he followed the Quran, he don't follow the Constitution of USA. Which one is more holy, the Constitution of USA or the Quran? I'm sure the answer is clear. It is the Quran. And the Quran say clearly, you cannot be sincere and friend them. You cannot be sincere and be fighting with them. You cannot be sincere and protect them or protect you, unless you are using them. And this guy is used by Clinton. However, he is doing the propaganda of Muslims because it's not for the benefit of the Muslim Abdul for Trump to win. And because of Trump, he is a person who says things as it is. As an example, he said about the wife of this man, properly she is not allowed to talk. Is it Trump is lying? No. Then they made her speak. And they say she was crying. She wasn't crying. You are a bunch of liars. If we go here, you will see Muhammad, he says, ناقصات عقل ودين. Women are half a brain. And most of them, they are in hellfire. So in Islam, Muslim women, she is no one. This is why Trump, he is not being a hypocrite. He is being truthful with you. He told you properly, she is not allowed to talk. And now they are in the corner, so they made her talk. Otherwise, why she did not talk in the conference? Why only the husband he talk? She is not the mother? And why she is in the stage if she will not talk? Muhammad said, no nation will be successful if their leader is a female. Can Hillary Clinton, she quote this verse to the Muslim guy in the stage? Can the scam of the Democrat tell us about Islam, the amazing religion, the one they are trying to defend? In the same time, which is very funny, their candidate for a presidency is a woman. Never will succeed such a nation as makes a woman their ruler. So how this Muslim, he agree that Hillary Clinton, she should be a president? Are you saying you as a Muslim, you agree that your prophet is a liar? Are you Muslim saying your prophet is a shish kebab dump idiot? Or you don't agree with him? Or you agree with him? We want to know. If you say you are a Muslim, it means you cannot vote for Hillary Clinton because it's against what is right and what's wrong. For your prophet, the prophet of the Abdul, the child molester, he said it clearly, a woman, she cannot be a leader. Then here, and this is my advice for all American, and please share this video everywhere. We have few months before the election, and those scumbags in Hillary Clinton gang, they will do their best to fight Trump so he will not win. Share this video, please. Everywhere. If Hillary Clinton, she support Muslims and Muslims support Hillary Clinton, then how Hillary Clinton, she is fit for the job if their prophet, and this is their holy God, Muhammad. Trust me, Muslims don't worship Allah. Muslims, they worship Muhammad. I can show you tons of quotes fighting over his water of washing his testicles with it. I can find you tons of quotes. Muslims are fighting over the water of his underwear. If Muhammad say women cannot be a good leader, then why the Muslims are voting for a woman? I will tell you why. Because those people, they want America to be destroyed in their mind. I'm not saying a woman, she can't be a good leader. Remember, in their mind, their prophet must be seen saying the truth. And that means if we choose a woman for America, as we see here, she will not be succeed. She will be a big failure for America. And this is why the Muslims, they want to vote for Clinton. This is not the only reason, by the way. And let me ask you a question, American. Do you think the devil, he love you? Islam hate you to death. So one question I want to ask before I finish this. Why Muslims want to vote for the Democratic Party when those people, they hate America to death? Isn't it? This is a good question. Take my advice, my friend. If the Muslims vote for Jesus, don't vote for him. It means that Jesus is not the true Jesus. Is that clear? If the Muslims ever vote for anyone, that means there is something very bad about him. Especially he will lead your country, not their country. They will never want something good for your country. This is why they voted for America. Obama, not America, USA. America, Obama, where after 8 years is nothing. So they don't want someone like Trump, who knows exactly what Muslims and Islam is about. This is a very dangerous person for them. And they say to you that Trump cannot be trusted with nukes. The funny, in the same time, they say to you that he have relationship with Putin. Hold on. How this one, he cannot be trusted with nukes and Putin want to support him. Putin should be the first one to be worried about someone cannot be trusted with nukes. He should not be relaxed. Don't make them fool you. When the election come, go and vote. And you have only one vote to cast. Vote for a Trump. And I am a Middle Eastern, and they call me an Arab. And I agree with this message. Because I love America. Because I am not from the religion of the Abdul. Because I am a Christian. Who been taught to love his neighbor and his enemy. But don't let your enemy fool you. The love into your enemy is by showing them the truth, not by giving them kisses, not by bowing down. This is not what you want to do. And this is what Hillary Clinton, she is trying to do for is a scumbag all what she wants in your money and the money of the Muslims and the money of the Arab. It's a business, nothing more. But don't let them win this election. I vote for Trump. So you vote for who? God bless.